最喜欢开会的民族了，但是根据我的经验，这个大会小会不断的开，常常开不到重点上面去，而且开完一轮之后呢，完全不晓得在讲些什么。这个时候你就应该要跳出来说一句 Let me get down to the main business. Let me get down to the main business. 让我们进入正题吧。
Is that all you wanted to see me about?
No, not quite. Now let me get down to the main business.
Okay.
The board of directors finally agreed to set up an overseas office in New York.
Oh, did they?
And they wanted me to ask if you are still interested in working abroad.
Let me get down to the main business. Let me get down to the main business.就是让我们打开天窗说亮话的意思。其实呢，还有另外一个说法，你也可以说 Let's get down to the heart of the matter. Let's get down to the heart of the matter. 也就是让我们把事情的重心拿出来讲吧。此外呢，还有一个非常类似的说法，就是 Let's get back to the business at hand.虽然也是让我们一起来讨论重点的意思，但是这个呢有一点点时间程度上的差别，因为这个 at hand 就是在手上的事情是比较紧急的事情，所以整句话的意思就是让我们一起来解决这个当务之急吧。
Let me get down to the main business.
当中投票有三种机制，第一个是赞成，第二个就是反对，第三个你也可以投弃权票。通常会投弃权票的人表示他是一个立场不坚定的人。什么样的人立场会不坚定呢？第一个，他可能真的不知道自己想要什么，还有一个可能其实他心里很清楚，只是他不想表态罢了。你也不想就一件事情来表态的话，你便可以说
I'm not so sure about that.
I'm not so sure about that.
What's happened to the communications project since then?
I'm not so sure about that. I think it was abandoned.
Was it? I thought it had just been suspended.
No. If it had just been suspended, it should have been brought up in the meeting at least as an addendum.
But just think about all the money that's been put into the project.
Actually, sometimes your heart is not in agreement, not agreeing, not believing. But in order not to let your friends, colleagues, or bosses down, so you chose a more diplomatic way of not agreeing, which is "I'm not so sure about that." But sometimes, if you really don't agree, you can also take the blame and say, "I don't think so."I don't think so. 我才不这么认为，或者是 I disagree. I disagree. 我不赞成，我不赞成。会议当中呢，我们会利用表决的方式来通过一些议案，但是其实很多真正重大的决定还是要操在老板的手上。如果老板当下不愿意做出任何决定的话，他可能会说 Please let me think it over. Please let me think it over. 让我再考虑考虑吧。如果你跟老板要求加薪的话，老板可能也会很模棱两可的告诉你 Please let me think it over.
Please let me think it over.
Is he really quitting?
Yes, he is. It seems he's been offered a better job by another firm.
Is there anyone to replace him?
Well, I just can't think of anyone offhand. But I'm sure there must be someone we'd like to promote.
To take over from him?
Yes. Please let me think it over.
Please let me think it over.Please let me think it over. 请让我再考虑考虑。通常呢，我们是要做出重大决定的时候才会用这样子的说法。甚至如果有人跟你求婚，你不能够马上决定的话，你也可以这样子回答他。还有另外一个说法，就是
Let me give it some more thought. Let me give it some more thought.
让我再好好的想一想吧。其实呢，你也可以很轻松的跟他说 ，I will see what I can do. I will see what I can do. 我让我看一看能为你做些什么，或者是 I will let you know later. I will let you know later. 我一会儿才让你知道我的决定。此外呢，还有一个非常好、非常通俗的用法，就是 Let me sleep on it.Let me sleep on it. 让我睡在这个上面。睡在什么东西上面呢？就是睡在这个问题上，睡在这个决定上。可能我一觉醒来之后呢，就会有决定了。其实也就是让我再考虑考虑吧。学校里面小朋友最喜欢听到老师说的一句话就是 take a break， 休息一下，下课了。其实呢，所有的这个 break 前面加上一个什么东西，例如 lunch break 就是午餐休息时间，或者是 tea break， coffee break 就是下午茶或者是咖啡的时间。其实有的时候呢，休息一下是为了走更长的路。所以如果你是大老板，开会开累了，你是不是应该跟你的员工说 shall we take a break for a while now
Shall we take a break for a while now?
Oh, there's still an enormous amount of work to do.
There sure is. Look at this pile of files to sort out.
Shall we take a break for a while now?
No, let's not. Otherwise, we won't be able to get through this today.
You're right.
Shall we take a break? Shall we take a break?我们休息一下好吗？其实说到这个 break， 除了有休息的意思之外呢，还有很多其他的用法。大家一定常常听说 give me a break， give me a break， 拜托啦。或者还有另外一个解释方式，就是请不要对我这么残忍，再给我一次机会吧。如果你有一个朋友跟我一样是做表演工作的话，你可以在他上舞台之前跟他说 break a leg。Break a leg， 当然不是让你的朋友上了舞台去跌断一只腿，而是要祝他好运。Break a leg。有的时候呢，我们会听到一些令人啼笑皆非的对话，我们称之为鸡同鸭讲。人家分明问了你一个选择题，但是你却把它当成是非题来回答，一会儿 yes yes yes， 一会儿 no no no。 其实呢，如果你在会议期间不小心闪了神，根本没有听清楚人家的问题，最好的方法呢，就是把人家的问题重复一次之后，然后再说 Is that what you are asking?
Is that what you're asking?
这就是你要问的问题吗？
Well, I'm a little bit hazy about your questionHow much is the national income per capita? Is that what you're asking?
No, it's not. What I'd like to know is if it has been rising in this country of late.
I understand.
May I draw your attention to this chart? Here. Obviously, it's increasing rapidly.
刚才在我们的状况剧里面，主角问到了 How much is the national income per capita?Is that what you are asking? 你的问题是不是每年的国民平均收入有多少呢？其实这样子的问法呢，能够确立这个问题的本质是非常恰当的表达方式。但是如果你根本连问题都没有听清楚的话，那又是另外一回事了。其实就算没有听清楚问题，也不是什么大不了的事情。你只要再问他 ，Would you mind repeating your question? Would you mind repeating your question?介不介意再把问题问一次呢？今天要教大家一个你会终生受用的一个字，那就是 appreciate。Appreciate， 这个字的中文意思呢是感谢跟欣赏的意思。为什么说你会终身受用呢？除了你要表示感激之外，有的时候你想要请别人帮你忙，甚至有点强人所难的时候呢，这句话都会非常好用。I know it's difficult, but I would appreciate it if you could. I know it's difficult, but I would appreciate it if you could. 我知道这很困难，如果你能够做到的话，我会非常感激你的。
We'd like to place an order for 1,000 units of this component.
You mean catalog number 2158?
Yes, and we need them immediately. Could we get them delivered this afternoon?
Well, I wish we could, but...
I know it's difficult, but we'd appreciate it if you could. We're completely out of stock at the moment.
I would appreciate it if you could. 真的是一句太棒太棒的话了。因为在这句话的后面呢，你可以加上所有合理或者甚至于是不合理的要求。例如你可以说 I would appreciate it if you could lower your voice. 如果你可以小声一点的话呢，我会非常感谢你。或者你也可以说 I would appreciate it if you could fly me to the moon.如果你能够把我飞到月球去的话，我会非常感谢你的。现在知道怎么用了吧？曾经看过一本企业书，说绝对要避免马拉松式的会议，长度最好维持在一个小时，即使是极限也不能超过两小时。所以如果时间差不多到了，这时候就应该要有人站起来说 I'm afraid there isn't much time left for further discussion today. 今天恐怕没有多余的时间进行继续的讨论，虽然可能会议没有办法完成，但是相信大家还会很高兴地说散会了。
Some of the problems we may face.
Well, as for tariffs, we found out that our products would not be liable for duty.
What about shipping facilities?
That can be a problem. There are very few direct sailings. Well, I'm afraid there isn't much time left for further discussion today. So may I suggest we discuss this at the next meeting?
I'm afraid there isn't much time left. 恐怕时间所剩不多了。或者你也可以说 I'm afraid we've run out of time. 恐怕我们把时间已经用完了。既然这个会开不完，有什么解决办法呢？其实你也可以建议说 I suggest we discuss it next time. 我建议下次我们继续讨论。其实呢，如果你常常喜欢看那些百万富翁的节目，你应该很熟悉这句话 Time's up, time is up, 表示时间到了。近几年经济低迷，失业率越来越高，裁员率也越来越高。据我的朋友说呢，每天进到公司里面最害怕的一件事情就是打开电脑之后看到一封来自老板的 email 告诉你对不起你被炒了。但是就算你早上逃过一劫，但是也难保下午老板是不是会来敲你的门然后告诉你 I wish I didn't have to say this but 我说不下去，你自己看吧。
Excuse me. I'd like to talk with you. Can you come to my office?
Yes, I'll be right over.
Have a seat.
Thank you.
I've been pleased with your work, but...
Yes?
I wish I didn't have to say this, but the board of directors has agreed to cut down on the present staff.
I knew sooner or later this time would come.
I wish I didn't have to say this, but you are fired. 我真希望我不用来告诉你，你刚刚被炒掉了。其实你只要听到前面这半句话，就知道后面那半句肯定不是什么好事情。你的太太可能会来跟你说 ，I wish I didn't have to say this, but I maxed out the credit card. 我真希望我不用告诉你，我刚刚把信用卡给刷爆了。或者是店员跑来告诉你 ，I hate to say this.But your car has been towed. 我真是很抱歉地通知你，你的车刚刚被拖走了。当你好心地要为你的朋友提出一些建议或者是想法的时候，其实有很多单词可以用的，例如有 suggest, advise, 或者是 propose。今天要教大家一句呢，是 What I suggest is this.
What I suggest is this.
What I suggest is this.
我要为你建议的如下。
I'm afraid the bank won't advance us the money. What shall we do?
Well, what I suggest is this.We should try a joint venture in order to raise the cash.
I see. Do you have any particular company in mind?
Yes. How about Johnson and Smith?
Just 为大家提供了三个不同的建议 suggest, advise, 以及 propose. 虽然都是提供建议，但是在程度上还是有相当大的不同。现在呢，我就要利用相同的主体餐厅来为大家举一些例子。例如我说 ，I suggest you go to another restaurant. 我建议你呢到别的餐厅去。为什么呢？只是提供一个建议给你，并没有干涉太多的个人情感在里面。但是如果我说，I advise you go to another restaurant. 这个时候呢，可能就有比较多的个人情感在里面。可能我曾经在那边吃过，我觉得不好吃，或者是我忠顾你，我忠告你，希望你不要去这家，因为它可能里面有老鼠。第三个说法呢是 I propose we close down this restaurant. 我提议，我建议，我希望我们把这家餐厅关掉。为什么呢？可能在赔钱，所以我强烈的建议，多半这个 propose 会用在生意上的往来，这样子你知道他们之间的区别了吧？在现代生活当中已经不复见了。现代人无论事情的大小，好像都要靠一张合约来相互的约束。即使像 Microsoft 这么大的公司呢，还是有可能和人家产生合约的纠纷。所以当你签订合约的内容的时候，这个字字句句可要细细的斟酌。如果你对于合约的内容有问题的话，你可以这么问 Does what it says here mean that blah blah blah? Question mark.请问你这个合约内容写的是不是代表 blah 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 然后加上一个问号
Before we sign this contract, may I confirm a couple of things?
Yes, of course. What are they?
Does what it says here mean that residual should be paid?
That's right.
And here, does it mean that the contract should be renewed only upon your request?
That's correct.
其实刚才前面教大家说的这个 Does what it says here mean that blah 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 比较容易出现在书写或者是文字当中如果你要用口语化而且是相同意思的话你也可以问说 Does this mean that blah 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 这是不是代表什么什么意思呢举一个例子 Does this mean that I can't get my money back?难道这表示我没有办法把我的钱拿回来了吗？感觉上是不是简单多了呢？ 要教大家一个非常重要而且又很好用的字，那就是 negotiate。negotiate 什么意思呢？那就是可以讨价还价，有商有量。相信大家都曾经看过英文的这些求财广告，里面应该是不陌生，会看到一句话 ：salary is negotiable， 薪水是可以商量的。当你在和人家讨论合约的内容的时候，有的时候你也要记得问一问 ，Are these terms still negotiable？ 请问里面的条约还有商量的余地吗
？Can you tell me a bit more about the terms?
Certainly. What else would you like to know?
What about paid holidays?
There are 3 weeks of paid holidays a year.
And does your company give a bonus?
No, it doesn't.
Are these terms still negotiable?
I'm afraid not.
Why do you say negotiate is a very important and useful word? Because this is a negotiation for price, not only can be used between two governments, but even between the terms of the war, or between the bosses.跟员工之间，甚至是消费者跟商店之间的讨价还价，其实你也可以跑去跟你的老板说 ，I would like to renegotiate my salary， 我想重新和你谈一谈我的薪水问题。其实呢，甚至于连男女朋友之间也是可以拿来讨价还价的。如果男朋友对你不好的话，你可以跟他说 ，I'm leaving you， that's not open to negotiation。我要离开你了，而且没有商量的余地。如果你曾经做过生意，相信你一定遇过这样子的人，不但是跟你攀亲带故，而且告诉你现在经济低迷，生意真的很不好做，而且他家里上有高堂老母，下面还有3岁的幼子，钱真的很不好赚。说了半天，他就是不告诉你，请你算我便宜一点好吗？遇到这样子的人，你也可以问他 ，May I ask what you are getting at？请问你到底是什么意思呢？
I wonder if you can get them done somehow in a way that...
May I ask what you're getting at?
Sure.
All I want to know is if it's possible to expect any reduction on these prices.
I'm afraid not. These are really our lowest wholesale prices.
I see.
Actually, due to the current oil shortage, material costs have gone up incredibly, you know.
其实相较之下呢 ，May I ask what you are getting at？ 我可不可以请问你到底是什么意思呢？已经是一个非常有礼貌的说法。如果你这只客人已经有一点点讨厌的话，你也可以问他说 ，What are you trying to say？ 请问你到底想说些什么？如果你已经对这个客人感到不耐烦的话，你还可以问他说 ，What's your point？ 请问你的重点在哪里？但是相信这个时候你也已经得罪了你的客人了。先礼后兵，先小人后君子。如果你在跟你的合作厂商，甚至是你的老板谈定合约的时候，记住了，可要逐项逐项的看清楚了。如果你看到的条款是模棱两可的话，你应该跟他说 ：Could you put that in more specific terms? Could you put that in more specific terms?你可以把这个条款写得具体一点吗
？We'd like to know what your plant is technically capable of.
Could you put that in more specific terms?
Certainly. What's your monthly production and quality control system?
I see. Our production manager can answer those queries for you. I'll go and get him.
有些人说起话来喜欢话中有话，让你听起话来像雾里看花。这个时候你可以问问他， Could you be more specific? 请问你讲话可以具体一点吗？或者你也可以问他， What exactly do you mean? What exactly do you mean? 你到底是什么意思呢？某些特定的原因，常常呢，这个医生都不能跟他的病人说实话。例如，你到牙医院里面去，希望能够做一点整形矫正的手术，但是医生从头到尾不愿意告诉你得拔掉几颗牙。这时候呢，你也可以单刀直入的问他 ，Doctor, to be more specific, how many teeth were you put out? 医生啊，具体的来说，你到底要拔掉我几颗牙呢？小的时候呢，如果有男孩子要约我们出去，总是要把爸爸妈妈拿出来当挡箭牌，说我要回去问问爸爸妈妈才知道。长大了之后进入商场，可能你的客户有时也会提出一些比较不合理的要求，你也可以把老板拿出来当挡箭牌。这个时候你就可以跟他说 Let me have a word with my boss first. Let me have a word with my boss first. 先让我跟我的老板谈一谈吧。
How long is the lease?
5 years.
Would it be possible to rent it for a shorter time?
I think it would, but let me have a word with my boss first. May I use your phone?
Sure. Go ahead. And would you ask if the rent is still negotiable or not?
看到了吗？像这样的房客是不是也是挺麻烦的呢？所以呢，还是要跟老板先谈一谈再说。除了刚刚我们以上的用法之外呢，你还可以说 I need to confirm with my boss first. I need to confirm with my boss first. 我得先跟我的老板确认一下再说。此外，还有一个说法是 Let me get authorization first. Let me get authorization first. 先让我拿到授权再说吧。可以走了。